Hello everyone, Alex here from warnoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can create a React app and upload it to an S3 bucket using CloudFront. So to get started, I'm going to create a very basic React application using Create React App. So now that we've created the React app, we're going to go ahead and open up VS Code inside of this directory, and we see our React app is right here. If we navigate into the folder, and we run npm run start, we're gonna see the React app actually open up and we'll see exactly what's inside. So here we see the very basic React app. We're not gonna make any changes to it. Of course, you can use your own React application. This is just something I'm gonna use to get started. Now we're gonna go ahead and use a script inside of our package.json. This is something that can be found in the video description. And this is a deploy script. So walking through it real quick, the first thing we're gonna do is build our project into a production ready state. And then we're going to go through and delete everything inside of an S3 bucket, which we'll create soon. This will make sure that any previous files that we might have deleted on our new project that we just built will actually still be there on the live website. And then after that, we're going to upload the files from our build folder, which you can see right here, into the S3 bucket. And we also want to make sure that everything is publicly readable. That way people can actually load the website. So again, the script will be in the video description. And of course, you want to change the S3 name right here to whatever S3 bucket yours is. Mine will be called warnoffkeys.com. And let's go ahead and save this. And we can go over to S3. And we're going to go ahead and create that right now. So warnoffkeys.com. We can then click on create. So navigated into the S3 bucket, we see there's no files as expected. Under the properties tab, we can click on static website hosting. We can click on use this bucket to host a website. index.html should be the index file that we use for both of these. We can click on save and everything should be set up with that. If we go into permissions under block bucket access or block public access, we can go to edit and we can uncheck this so everything will be public. That way people can actually load the files. We can click on save. We want to type in confirm. We then want to go to bucket policy and we're going to paste in a policy here. This will be something you can find in the video description. And the resource right here, this is actually going to be the ARN for the bucket. We want to just change this to whatever you have for your bucket name. Mine is warnoffkeys.com, so it should say warnoffkeys.com right here. We can save this, and if we go back to our course configuration, we can also paste this in, and again, this will also be in the video description, so you can easily copy and paste it. Nothing to change here. We can click on save. We can go back to our properties. We can go to static website hosting. We can click on this link right here for the endpoint. And we see 404 not found, so there's nothing actually here. So now if we go back to our console and we stop the process and we run npm run deploy, it'll build the React app and then upload it to the S3 bucket. So now it's built. If we refresh this website, we'll just see the actual React app here. And if we go back to the overview of our S3 bucket, we see the actual files here. So everything seems to be working so far. The next step is we're going to open up our CloudFront manager. So here we're going to create a distribution. We're going to select web. The origin domain name should be the exact bucket, .s3.amazonaws.com. If you click on it, you'll see a dropdown. We want to scroll down. We're going to leave all the stuff blank. In the future videos, I'm going to show you how you can redirect HTTP to HTTPS, as well as how to set up a certificate for free. We want to compress objects automatically. We scroll down further. And again, in future videos, I'll show you how to set up SSL as well as set up custom domain names. We're not going to do that in this video, though. Everything else seems fine. We're going to click on create distribution. And this might take a few minutes as it says in progress right here. So now the state is enabled. If we go ahead and copy the domain name, we open a new tab. We see we actually get an error here. That's because I forgot something. If we go to the distribution under general, if we click on edit, the default root object should be index.html. If we scroll down, we click yes, edit. And we go back to our distributions, we see it's in progress. Now we see it's enabled. If we go back to the website and we refresh, we see the actual React app on the CloudFront.net domain. In future videos, I'm going to show you how you can connect your own domain name to your CloudFront distribution, as well as how to get SSL set up. Thanks for watching this AWS tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, be sure to leave a comment down below or ask in the WarnoffKeys Discord, which can be found in the video description. If you want to learn more about AWS, consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.